Welcome to the presentation of Malayalam poetry in the 20th century, in which we are going to deal with the second generation romantics in Malayalam literature. Of the three poets, Ashan, Ullur and Vallathol, it was Vallathol, the youngest, that attracted the largest following in his lifetime and enjoyed the greatest popularity. Among those who were close to him in style are Nalappattu Narayana Menon, Kuttipurathu Keshavan Nayar, K.M. Panikkar, G. Shankarakuruppu, Pallathu Raman, Bodheshwaran, Vennikulam Gopalakuruppu, P. Kunniraman Nayar, Pala Narayana Nayar, M. P. Appan, and Balamani Amma. Nalappattu Narayana Menon is mainly remembered for his classic elegy on the death of his wife, Kannuneer Thulli or Teardrop, one of the best meditative lyrics in Malayalam. The philosophical strain, which is an undercurrent of romantic poetry, makes Nalappattu Narayana Menon closest to Ashan. Of all the poets in the Vallathol school, Kuttipurathu Keshavan Nayar, in his poem Gramina Kanyaka or The Village Maid, wrote about the simple joys of the rural society that were threatened by the prospect of urbanization. Pallathu Raman mainly wrote poems of social revolt. K.M. Panikkar, also a historian in English and a novelist in the Sevi tradition, came under the influence of early Vallathol and wrote poems in several categories. G. Shankarakuruppu, brought up in the classicist tradition of Ullur and Vallathol, fell early under the influence of Rabindranath Tagore and emerged as one of the major voices in 1930s. He passed through various stages of evolution marked by movements such as mysticism, symbolism, realism and also socialist realism. Among his major lyrical and meditative poems are Nakshatra Geetam or Song of the Star, Surya Gandhi, That Sunflower, Innu Nyan Nalani, Today I, Tomorrow Do, Nimisham, The Moment, and Vishwa Darshanam, The Cosmic Vision. They are all imbued with a spiritual earnestness which often brings him closer to the poetry of Kumaran Ashan. His dramatic monologue, Perinthachan, the Master Carpenter, is one of the successful poems in that category in Malayalam. Vennikulam Gopalakuruppu has stayed more or less within the Vallathol framework but has achieved some fine effects in his best poems about scenes in everyday life. P. Kunniraman Nayar was an untiring champion of the native tradition of life and an unwavering admirer of the beauty of Kerala landscape. Nalappattu Balamani Amma is the greatest poetess Kerala has produced so far. She is equally good at domestic themes and at speculative philosophy. Her longer monologues based on Parashurama, Vishwamitra, Mahabali and Vibhishana add a new dimension to Vallathol's portrayals of Puranic characters and episodes. Two poets, Idappalli Raghavan Pillai and Changampuzha Krishnan Pillai, brought in a new breadth of life into the Malayalam poetry of 1930s. Idappalli Raghavan Pillai, one of the true inheritors of unfulfilled renown among modern Malayalam poets, brought out and emphasized the finer elements which were often muted in the poems of the Vallathol school. His poetry reminds us of a vibrant melody played on a single string instrument. Before he committed suicide in 1936, he wrote a few excellent lyrics in the purer romantic strain with no hangover from neoclassicism. The close alliance between nature and the poet's mood of the moment is a recurrent theme in his work. The double distilled essence of romantic lyricism tender and delicate and wistful, never before or after in the history of Malayalam poetry has been captured in words. Idappilly Raghavan Pillai has been compared by A. Balakrishna Pillai to Leopardi of Italy. The brooding melancholy of an autumnal afternoon lingers over the poems of both. Raghavan Pillai's best poem is perhaps Maninadam, the sound of the bells, which ends with a quiet prayer. His companion, Changampuzha Krishna Pillai, met the same challenge of life with greater resilience. But deep down in him too, there glowed an incurable idealism which saw the world in primary colors. Changampuzha's most popular work is a pastoral play in verse called Ramanan. It is a dramatization of the life and death of Raghavan Pillai presented in idealized terms. Its romantic melodies have captured the loveliness of the landscape of Kerala with its evergreen trees and its numerous rivers. With Changampuzha, Malayalam poetry comes directly under the influence of world poetry other than English too. He was a prolific writer with an ever-widening readership. He was susceptible to different kinds of influence from time to time. He has written poems both extolling Vedic culture and condemning it vehemently. It has denounced socialism and has hailed Marx. These contradictions exist only on the intellectual plane. The magic of his poetry subsumes all these paradoxes. His last collection of poems, Swararaga Sugda, represents his art at its most mature. Rakkiligal, Night Bird, is in the form of a duet recited by a young man and a young woman calling upon the sleeping world to awaken to a new day better and brighter than ever before. Manaswini, Woman with a Generous Heart, is an autobiographical poem in which the poet pays his homage in a glowing words. Changampuzha passed away in 1948, and with that the magic world of Romanticism too came to an end. In the 30s and 40s, realism had threatened to creep into Malayalam poetry but never could raise its head very high. Idisheri Govindan Nair was one of the first poets to use a non-romantic diction and talk about the problems of life with precision and sharpness. Rural life and industrial life appear in his poems like Puttan Kalavum Arivalum, The New Pot and the Sickle, Panimudakku, Strike, in a naked and no too musical verse. Changampuzha's protest songs were so agreeable that they often lulled both the rebel and his opponent into the luxury of a daydream. Idasheri made the rebel think and understand before rushing into a fury of violence. Vailapilli Sridhara Menon is perhaps the last of our major links with Vallathol. He survived the flood tide of the poetry of Changampuzha, his exact contemporary. He started publishing collections late, and in the late 40s and 50s, he wrote some of his very best poems. He had once declared himself to be a poet of beauty, but later extended the meaning of the word beauty to cover all aspects of life. His poetry gained in depth and complexity in the years that followed. His most popular poem is Mambalam, Ripe Mango, a very early work illustrating the Wordsworthian view that children are prophets. Among his more mature works are Sahyende Magan, Son of the Western Gods, presenting with sympathy and understanding the troubled thoughts of a temple elephant in the process of going crazy and running amok. The romantic strain is not absent in him. For example, Oonyalin Mel, On the Swing, but it does not lead to uncontrolled outburst or overflow or loose meanderings. He always exercises severe control over his matter and manner. Seldom does he tolerate sentimentality or melodrama.
His most ambitious poem is perhaps Kudiyozhikkal Eviction, a kind of lyrical dramatic narrative in which the poet tries to dramatize his own ambivalence versus the community at large and to clarify the role of the poet in a world of changing values.
The Idappalli school continued for a little while in the 50s as in the works of P. Bhaskaran. Other greatest poets of this period are N. V. Krishnavaryar, Akkitham Achyuthan Nambudiri and Olappamanna. That's all about the topic, second generation romantics in Malayalam literature.
Hope you understood the topic. Thank you for watching.